What's up YouTube? My name's Kenneth. Today I have another Photoshop tutorial on how to edit the Milky Way, but this time we're going to focus on color correction of the foreground. And so as you can see here, we have another time-lapse sequence. This was shot with my Canon T3i on a telescope mount, and as you can see, it's tracking. Let's look at the metadata here. This one was a 40-second shot at f2.8 and ISO 1600, and normally 40 seconds would give you star trails because the sky would track out of the image or would track with image, but this time the camera is on a mount tracking the sky, and so the stars are nice and sharp, but the foreground is a little blurry, but you can barely notice. And so that's how I was able to get a 40 second image at ISO 1600, and that's how I can kind of keep the noise down, get a longer exposure and a lower ISO. So as you can see, all these images have settings associated to their raw files, but this one doesn't, so we're going to start with this one. And if you watched my last tutorial, I went in depth on what I do here in Camera Raw, but I'm going to kind of do it quickly here. So we're going to bump up the exposure, we're going to fix the white balance of the Milky Way, make that just right. That's probably too high. There, it looks pretty good. And then we're going to go into details, and we're going to fix some of we're going to do some noise reduction here, make that look really good. And I think the last thing I'm going to do is vignetting. Let's get rid of the vignetting a little bit. And the reason why I like to get rid of vignetting, a lot of people kind of think it looks good with a lot of vignetting, is because at the end you might want to crop it, and if you crop it, it might look funny with one corner really dark and another corner not so dark. So I like to get rid of the vignetting so I can crop later. That's why I do that. So I think that looks pretty good. Okay, so there's probably more we could do, but let's leave it like that, and we'll open the image and we can start working in Photoshop. So here we are in Photoshop, and we're going to do three basic things. First, we're going to work on the ground. You can see the ground looks kind of blue, and that's from the LED light I used. Usually I use a warmer LED light, but this I kind of left spur of the moment to shoot here, and I didn't have access to my nicer light. And because of that, we have a blue look on the ground. The LED was very directional, it was not very diffuse, and so we have a really bright top part of the tree, but the bottom of the tree is kind of darker, so it's not very evenly lit. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to fix the blue ground, then we're going to fix the uneven lighting on the tree, then we're going to kind of do color correction on the tree in general, and last we'll deal with the Milky Way in the background. Okay, so first thing is let's create a folder, and I like using folders lately. We'll call this one ground, and in the ground we're going to give a hue saturation. So first we want to make this hue saturation not apply to the entire image, we just want to make a mask. So I'm going to give it the hue saturation, I'll make really bright so I can see what the mask is doing, and then we can select the mask. Let's invert the mask with Control I, so now the mask is black. And we can then start painting the mask white. Let's give it a little bit bigger brush. That's pretty good. And we just want to paint the ground. And what we're doing is we're painting our mask here. And so then we can give a hue saturation that only affects the ground. And we definitely want to get this log here because that's very blue. And we want to come up into the tree here where it's kind of darker, where it's kind of blue. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, now let's go back to the hue saturation. Of course, we want to get rid of that lightness we gave it. So I like to use this the little hand tool here. It's really helpful. What we want to do is we want to select the color that we don't like. And so it's too blue in the ground, so we can select with the little eyedropper something that's very blue. So we'll select over here. In the hue saturations, we can see blues have been selected, and in the spectrum down here, we can see what part of the blues are selected. Now, when we change the hue saturation or lightness now, it's only going to affect the blues, and only this part of the spectrum will be affected. So right now, the ground is too blue. So to get rid of the blueness, all you have to do is bring down the saturation. So let's drop the saturation of the blues to about here. And you can see now everything that was blue down below is no longer blue. Let's turn it off. So this here we can see it's blue, and now you can see it's not blue. And just doing that really adds. I mean, that really helps a lot with the color correction of this image. Something we can do that I like, say we wanted to edit the ground even further, maybe give it a curve or something like that. You can actually grab the mask here from the hue saturation and drop it onto our folder. So now we can then select like a curve, and the curve will be in this folder, and when we use this curve, you can see it only affects the ground. So that's something I've done a lot, I find really useful. But you know, I don't think we need that much more here, so we can just leave it. Okay, so now let's work on this tree. And the first thing we see with the tree is the top part of the tree is bright and the bottom part of the tree is dark. It's very uneven. So let's give it another folder, and this folder we're going to call tree. Okay, in the tree folder, let's give it a curve, and we want to select kind of this area here. So let's give it a bright curve. Obviously, we don't want to do that to the entire image. So we can invert the mask with Control I, and using a brush, so B for brush, we can paint white on the tree on the part that we want to brighten. As you can see, I'm using a very soft brush here. That looks pretty good. We can zoom in here and use a smaller brush here. Obviously, that's too big. We can go up here like that. We can do it over here as well. And let's zoom back out. And we can see that's really helped kind of even out the lighting on the tree. But as you can see, you know, the mask is still kind of harsh, and we might want this mask to bleed a little further up the tree. And so one way we can do that is we can select the mask and use the lasso. Okay, so we can go up high on this tree and select, make a selection, and we can actually go up these branches as well. And this doesn't have to be too perfect. And we'll make a nice wide selection over here. So here's our selection, and what we can do now is we can now blur the mask so that it bleeds further up the tree and it's kind of more unnoticeable, and also further down the ground. Usually I'll hit the Alt button and click on the mask so you can see the mask as it's happening, but with the screencasting software I'm using, Alt is not working, so I won't do that. Let's just go up to Filter and Blurs and Gaussian Blurs, and we'll zoom out here and we'll take a look at what's happening, and you can see here is our mask. And the blur is being affected there, and we can get the blur. We don't want to go too far. You can see it gives these lines around the mask. So we want it to kind of just go up, and we want the mask to bleed up the tree and also down to the bottom. And I think right about there looks pretty good. We can hit OK. Obviously, our curve is still too high. Let's bring that down to something more reasonable, something we actually want. About there looks really good. And then we can zoom in around the bottom, and there might be some mistakes around the bottom. Using a brush, we can get a small brush. What's going on here? Select that. Okay. And we want to paint kind of black along these edges here and make sure that they look right. Also in that hole there. We don't want it really to affect the Milky Way at all. Okay, that looks great. So now we have much more even lighting on the tree. You can see before it was dark on the bottom, and now it looks a little brighter. You can get it a little brighter if you want to make it look as even as you like. I think there looks really even. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to color correct the tree. Now that it's all one kind of color, one brightness, we can now color correct this tree. And so let's give it a color balance, because to me it looks a little too blue. So we can do color balance, and you can, you know, make it really warm by making it very yellow. And obviously we don't want it to apply to everything, so we got to give it a mask. So let's use the quick selection tool and we can select the tree. Once we have a selection, we can delete here, and obviously we've gone inverse of what we want, right? So we can deselect everything and hit Control I to invert the image, and we can see we made a pretty bad selection here, so we can go ahead and fix that. Maybe we can select this part here, and we can delete that. Oh, delete it now. There we go, that's better. We can use a brush to kind of add more to the selection that needs to be added. Like over here, doesn't look like it's been affected. Okay, so we have a selection. We definitely want to blur the bottom of the selection, so let's go ahead and do that. Let's use lasso. So we can select this bottom part, and we can do we can go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Let's zoom out on this, and we kind of want it just to soften the bottom part here, so about there probably. Hit OK, and that's looking pretty good for a decent selection. But now let's go to color balance. Now that we have our selection, we can get the color balance just right. And by itself, it's too blue. So we want to give it some yellow to warm it up. And when we give it too much yellow, it starts looking a little green. So we need to add some magenta as well. And eventually you get something that looks more natural. To me, that looks better. You can see before it's blue, and now it's a little oranger, a little more warmer. So that looks better. Now there's still some problems with this. You can see that to me it looks too bright. I mean, when you look at a picture at night, your eyes don't pick up the brightness here, and so and also it's too vivid. You see more black and white at night, and this is too colorful for me. And so what I'd like to do is I'd like to create another folder inside of Tree. And we'll put it in Tree, and we'll call this one kind of like the whole tree. Or full tree. Let's call it full tree. We'll put this color balance in full tree. Oops, I put the mask on there. Let's take the whole thing, put it in full tree. In fact, let's do that. Let's put the mask on the folder. And now we can add a hue saturation to the folder. And we can just desaturate this. So we can pull down the saturation here. And if we go all the way, it turns the tree black and white. But we don't want black and white. We do want some color in there. We just don't want it quite as vivid. So we can bring down the saturation to about here. So we can see before it's too orange. Now it brings down the saturation a little bit. And if you wanted to, you could use the hand dropper. And there's parts of the tree that still looks too blue. So we can select maybe a blue part of the tree. You can see it's found that this is the blue area. And we can desaturate the blues a lot. There we go. I think that looks better. Okay, so now we've got something that's a little more black and white, not quite as saturated, but it's still too bright. It looks to me like there's a headlight on this tree, and we want it to look like it's lit up by the stars themselves. So let's add a brightness contrast, and we can just bring down the brightness of this tree to make it look more as if it were lit by starlight. But you definitely want to see it, you just don't want it to be quite so bright. And you might need to adjust the contrast as well to make it match the rest of the image. Alright, this is looking really good. We can go into the first curve. It looks too bright down here, and so we might need to adjust this curve here and darken this area up a little bit. That looks better. We can also see there's parts of the tree that weren't affected by the brightness contrast we just did, because it's not in the curve. And so the nice thing about using one curve on this folder is, instead of having to change this curve here for the brightness contrast once and then also having to change it to the hue saturation, it's only here on the folder, so we can do it at the same time. So we can go to the brush and we can start painting in areas that weren't affected, like this part here needs to be darkened. And you can adjust the mask and make it better, and you can spend a lot of time on the mask, and it's often time well spent. And I'm not spending that time right now, just because this is a quick tutorial, and I want to really focus on other parts because you can learn how to mask in different parts, different places. Okay, so we have a good looking tree. Now all that's really left is to do the background, to do the Milky Way. So we can give it another group, and we call this group, and call that one sky. Okay, for the sky, this Milky Way already looks really good. So there's not very much we need to do. So I might just give it one curve adjustment, and we might. I usually use this little hand picker here to select a part in the dark area of the Milky Way and one in the bright part of the Milky Way, and you can see those two spots are represented here on the curve, and we can brighten the top part to make contrast in between those two areas and darken this part here. And as you can see, this affected the entire image, and we don't really want that, so we have to change this mask here, and we can use a brush. Let's use a bigger brush, something like that, and we want to paint black onto here so that we don't affect the foreground at all. So we want to paint this. And often you might steal from some of the other masks you've already done, and that's perfectly fine. In fact, I would normally do that. You can use Alt to click on a mask, and you can see only the mask, and you can copy that mask and then paste it somewhere else. So that is a good little tip. But for now, I'm just doing a quick mask. And there we go. I think we've got ourselves a good looking image. You can spend some more time on the masks and you can make it look even better. But now we have a great image of the Milky Way. Now this was done real quick for you guys here on YouTube. If you want to see my final image, I'll put a link to that in the description. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you guys. And if it was, please let me know. Also, if you see something I have done that I could have done much better or easier, let me know. I've learned a lot from the comments I've gotten. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Check out my tutorial, the other tutorials I've done. Also, check out my time lapses, and let me know what you guys think. All right, thanks guys for watching, and of course, have a great day.